For those of you wondering where last week's what's wrong with you is, my internet service provider, the bed, like just brown and nutty bed. I was having, I'm trying to describe it quickly without, you know, taking up too much time, but it's having incredible packet loss, which was the signal from one end of my computer wasn't getting into the rest of the internet. And they came out to check out my connections. The connections inside were fine. The technician went out and checked the wire that comes from the telephone pole to the cable box. And I don't know how, if many of you know how your internet works, you might just think it's magic. That's fine. But there is a wire that comes from the telephone pole to the cable box. It is a coaxial cable. It was full of water. I don't know how. Yeah, that's right. I'm kind of sitting here going, well, that doesn't seem
kind
like
a thing that's supposed to be full of water.
Yeah. Had to replace that line, and then we thought it was all fixed. And then it wasn't. It started doing it again that very day. And then suddenly it's fine. And it's been fine ever since. And we've been able to stream and everything works. And
it's magic.
Internet. Ooh la la. Internet, man. This week we have, we're going to get to the story eventually. We have a story that's kind of, this has never happened, which is terrible on this show.
Yeah.
Like, if we have a
I kind of feel like we've seen it all.
And if we haven't, it's terrible. So we'll get there. But we also have the normal assortment of, yeah. So let's get it running and underway. Give me that intro.
I'm gonna fuck my bangs while you do that.
Each week, Catherine. Radio Dead Air Audience Club, worldwide interwebs. Find all sorts of horrible stuff. Bring you back here for a little segment. We like to call crazy. What the fuck is wrong with you? And we're going to start with a cut. I guess this was a, for us, this is a feel good story. We are, of course, in the midst of a fucking war, which is terrible. But even somehow, that can cross over into our wheelhouse, and
it shouldn't.
You know what? I don't mind this one. I don't think anyone really does, because this guy, his genitals have their own gravity. Like, not even light can escape. That's how heavy they are. Ukrainian man partially sinks yacht of Russian CEO selling weapons. This guy. What?
Just wow.
Now, I want to point out here, I want to clarify, nothing was sunk. There was no sinking. Nothing was partially sunk. This was, in fact, a submerging operation. Flying over Tara's head. We'll get to her in a second. No sinking. This wasn't sinking. Don't call it a sinking in the media. Oh. There you go. Took a second. Okay. Click. Ukrainian man, Ukrainian ship member, reportedly
crew.
Yep, crewman reportedly tried to sink a yacht owned by the CEO of a Russian weapons manufacturer in protest over the Russian invasion of Ukraine. 55-year-old Ukrainian, who is identified as D. Teres O, tried to sink the boat by flooding the engine room by opening a large valve as well as another one in a different part of the boat. The yacht, called Lady Anastasia, the sheer bad taste of someone in modern Russia naming their yacht after anyone from that family. Reported belonged to Alexander Majiv, the Russian CEO of Rosoboron Export, a Russian military weapons company. The man then shut down the electricity, closed the fuel valves before asking three Ukrainian crew members to leave the ship. And the crew members, who later reported him to authorities, called him crazy and asked him to close the valve that was causing the leak. The yacht was left with a destroyed engine room. The man's motivation to sink the yacht: Ukraine was being attacked, he said, by missiles manufactured by the owner's company. When he appeared before the judge on Sunday, the 55-year-old said he doesn't regret his actions and that he would, quote, would do it again.
The other guys.
Fuck them. He was released on charges, said he committed as material damage and no intention of human damage. I've read in others that he's been released and he's going to go back to Ukraine to fight. So this dude just plain up, well, fuck it.
I can't blame him.
I mean, really? Of all the things to do, he's just like, well, fuck this yacht. I'm down with that.
Guy in Ireland today took his work truck and drove it through the front gates of the Russian embassy.
I don't think they quite know what to do with this. I think they're kind of confused about how this would be.
I think it would be a lot easier. And it has not at all been easy. They're kind of getting their asses kicked.
Yeah. They thought this
And nobody's on their side. And I don't know why they thought anybody would be on their side. But they clearly did.
Well, they
clearly
thought
they'd have some allies here.
They have this history, and this is how it works. This is how it works under Trump as well. He's getting political. Fuck you. The way it works is...
We have pretty much traditionally let them get away with it.
Yeah, well, they would tell a lie, and they would dare us to contradict them. And if it got to the point they tell so many lies so often, so constantly, we're just like, oh, fucking whatever. And we're done. But that's not working anymore because we are past done and we're all just like, oh, fuck this shit. We're not playing this game anymore. Fuck this. Because it's like, if you call us on this lie, we'll hurt you for it. We'll make you pay for it. That's the entire premise of how these work. You just be brazen about it. Yeah.
I know this is a little premature, but one of the things we have learned this week, if you're watching the news at all, is you don't want to fuck with Ukrainians.
Ukrainian farmers will steal your tank. That's been amazing.
They do not fuck around.
No.
A dude blew himself up just to take out a bridge that they were going to use to get into his city. Like, these people do not fuck around. Do not get in a fight with Ukrainian. They will fuck you up.
Now let's get back to general stupid, because we have quite a bit. This is Florida, of course, and I do not understand. We will never understand. This has happened so many times. This is a regular occurrence, this story. It's just, it's not so much how the story happens, it's what goes where. That's the part that keeps surprising us these days with these stories. Florida man stuffs stolen crossbow down pants. February 6th, employees of the True Value store in Mims, Florida found that two crossbows have been stolen. A man, later identified as Darren Durant, was seen on video surveillance walking into the store. Oh yeah, that's right. We've got video for this. So you can.
Darren Durant stole a crossbow.
Yeah.
So this is if you order Daryl Dixon off Wish, I guess.
Where is it? There it is. This is. I don't. Yeah, if you want to see the, here we go, just strolling down the aisle, casual as you please, and crossbow into his pants.
Do you think nobody would notice? You can't even pull your pants up.
Yeah, and he's just like, well, I'm just gonna, let's see,
sir.
And the crutch. Okay, can we pull? Let's skip back a bit. Enhance. Enhance. Let's start that again. I want to get to this one. Okay. Let's see if I can make this a wee bit larger here. If you look into the crotchal area The No, sir, that is not you. Don't try to pretend that's you. That's not you. He's like, what? You're gonna, that's it's a gift. What can I say? No, no, sir, that is not you. I don't know how you thought that is not you.
Shaped like that, you should definitely see a doctor.
And the crutch is just, oh, you fucking asshole. What?
They caught him on the way out of the store, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Just the fucking audacity. No, he got out undetected.
Come on.
A couple of days later, Durant was taken into custody after running from a deputy in a nearby Walgreens parking lot. Arrest warrant for Durant for felony petty theft, as well as two prior felony theft convictions.
It had to be just like the corporate loss prevention bullshit that let him walk out of that store. Because there's no way they didn't notice.
They know.
But, you know, like if they didn't see him pick it up and conceal it.
A crossbow.
Maybe he's going to Ukraine too?
A crossbow. Why? In your pants. A crossbow. Oh, Genku, so he bolted. Oh.
I mean, at least that is better than a gun down the pants, because
Yeah.
You're not going to shoot your own dick off. So I guess points for that.
The thing is, this is not one of those, you just walk into a store and go, hey, a crossbow, I'm gonna steal that, put it in my pants. No, they planned this shit.
Yeah.
You're like, okay, all I gotta do is throw it in my pants, get out. I will grant him this. He's wearing his mask. Which, that's one of the things that just blows my mind about this era. You the perfect way to avoid being identified, but your stubborn, yeah, shitty, stupid ass won't do it even when you're committing crimes.
Yeah.
I mean,
but freedom.
Like, just the bulge is just
ridiculous.
Yeah.
Why would you not wear a long coat? I mean, I know it's Florida and it's like 80 degrees there year round, but you're already wearing like a jacket.
Well, next one is, I don't know how you. You ever seen someone do something with this wide-eyed, ridiculous assumption that this terrible thing they're about to do is going to be okay with everybody?
Yeah.
And just be baffled by why it isn't? It's so confusing, right? It's like, how could you think that was okay?
I mean, if anybody watched this season of Love is Blind and watched the reunion this week, we all saw it.
This one's bad. A school teacher suspended after using image of bin Laden in an attempt to portray Prophet Muhammad in a lesson. All Saints Academy in Dunstable apologized for the, quote, deep hurt and distress that's been caused in the Muslim community. You think? Teacher has been suspended after using an image of Osama bin Laden to portray the Prophet Muhammad during a religious studies lesson. Here, 10 students were shown an image of the 9/11 terrorist in class at All Saints Academy in Dunstable. It's unclear why the image was used.
You're not even supposed to have images of the Prophet Muhammad.
Which is why the image was used. Well, you can't.
It's an iconoclast religion.
I can't. If I can't show the image, I'll just do this. You know that's why it was. Because most Muslims consider depictions of Muhammad or any other prophets of Islam to be deeply offensive. School said it became aware of the incident after a concerned student raised the alarm. The member of the staff being suspended immediately. I mean, what? What did I do? It's free. It's free speech. What did I do? What did I do?
Like, it's called All Saints Academy, so I'm assuming.
Yeah.
It's either Catholic or Church of England. Doesn't fucking matter. If you don't want the public school down the street to depict Larry the fucking cable guy on a crucifix and tell everyone that's our Lord and Savior. And you're not supposed to depict the prophet at all.
And yay. Did he say unto his fellow followers, get her done.
Get her done.
And they did get her done. And it was good.
Like, you double fucked up. It's an iconoclast religion.
Right.
And you're like, gosh, I can't find a picture of the guy. What do I do? I'm going to use the guy that caused pretty much every Muslim in America or Europe to just be treated like shit for years.
And you know that, you know these teachers. You know this exact type of teacher. Like, what did I do? What did I do?
Well, I needed something for the slide.
No, no, you didn't. It's just, it's no. You're a fucking teacher. Why do they? Some people just should not be letting their kids.
And like, if it's a Catholic school, Catholics love iconography.
Yeah.
We love our stained glass windows, our statues, our little medallions. Like, so. Catholics that don't study other religions might be a little confused by an iconoclast religion, but fuck you.
Well, I forget which comic it was said that everybody's got crucifixes up, wearing crucifixes around their neck. But do you really think Jesus is ever going to want to see a crucifix ever the fuck again when he comes back?
Wouldn't that be a nightmare? You come
right?
back and they're just everywhere.
We love you. Here's you on the crucifix. We love you.
Really, guys? We couldn't do like a fish. Remember that time I made all those fish? That was cool.
That was cool. The fish were cool. We
couldn't.
The fish.
We couldn't do that.
Yeah.
Some
of them have the fish. A couple of them have the fish. Some of them have the fish. Some of them.
Yeah.
Not as many as should have. Okay, this one's from Georgia, and the fucking audacity of this lady. I will give her props for props, actually. Georgia state official accused of faking pregnancies to get out of work, collect pay. A colleague reported seeing the lower portion of Robin Folsom's stomach, quote, come away from her body. A review of records found no sign she delivered a real child. What?
Co-worker was, can you imagine if you honestly thought your coworker's pregnant and her belly just fucking detached?
Right, because you see like under the shirt, the belly just goes like, like.
Can you imagine the panic?
State officials accused of faking multiple pregnancies and using at least one of the ruses to get out of work and to be paid for the time off. Fulton County jury convicted Robin Folsom, former director of external affairs at the Georgia Vocational Rehabilitation Agency, on 3 felony counts of making false statements. He's also charged with 1 count of identity fraud, also a felony. Folsom, 43, had supervised the agency's marketing and media communication. October 2020, Folsom told human resource officials that she was pregnant. Announced she had given birth in May of 2021. A man claiming to be the child's father later emailed the agency claiming that Folsom needed several weeks of rest after the birth. The agency approved about 7 weeks of paid leave, but soon the scheme began to unravel. Inspector General's office said a co-worker reported seeing the lower portion of Folsom's stomach come away from her body and shared with investigators a belief that Folsom wore a fake pregnancy stomach. She also sent pictures of her new baby to agency employees. The pictures seem to depict children, quote, with varying skin tones. She couldn't even use the same baby.
No, this was always destined to fall apart because here in the American dystopia, your health insurance goes through your job.
Right.
And at some point, they're going to notice that you weren't in the hospital. Mm-hmm. Or somebody's going to ask why you have not added your children to your health insurance.
So, so what's your child's name? Table, coffee mug?
Insurance, what's the security number?
Call him Muggy for short.
This is not a long-term con that you can, this is not sustainable.
Oh, Leighton. Ironically, she did this to, she did all this to avoid going into labor. That's terrible. That's terrible.
Like, just the health insurance alone makes this unsustainable.
Oh, ultimately, review of medical and insurance records said found no sign that Folsom delivered a real child. She had earlier reported the birth of a child in July 2020, claimed she was pregnant again in August 2021. Like, I would like to think if I was going to do crime that I would put a little more effort into it. This is insulting to me.
You got to think of the sustainability of the con.
Like, if I was the authorities charged with investigating this, I would take this as a personal insult. I was like, how stupid do you think I am? Like, this isn't some Lex Luthor shit here. This is some Zack Snyder Lex Luthor shit here.
Yeah.
It's Jesus Christ.
I've had jobs I fucking hate.
Yeah.
I've had jobs I dread going into every day.
Yep.
It never occurred to me to fake a pregnancy to take 7 weeks off. Now, granted, I haven't worked the kind of job where you got maternity leave in a long ass time. Yeah. So maybe that's why. But I would assume that if I faked a pregnancy at some point, I would be expected to produce a small human.
Like,
and that's not easy to do.
Imagine,
if you have not produced a small human.
Imagine going up to some lady on the playground like, excuse me, can I rent your child? Next one is from your neck of the woods, Tara. And we have, in the modern era, of course, we have so many things delivered. And we have to deal with the plague of porch pirates who will steal any package as long as it's unattended. Any package. This is the first time ever. Box of human heads stolen from truck in Denver.
Yeah. You'll hear, man.
Police in Denver investigating the theft of a box of human heads from a parked truck in the city last week. The heads were marked for medical research and were inside a box labeled exempt human specimen. The truck was parked in the East 23rd Avenue when the thief broke into the freight company's truck sometime between 2:30 p.m. and 9:30 a.m. Thursday and left with the box of human remains and a dolly.
The truck containing the box of heads was left unattended all that time.
It's unclear if the suspect was aware what was inside of the box. That's the best part. You see, exempt human specimen, what does that tell you as a layperson? So
you don't want to take it, honestly, because that could be little cups of pee,
But you get the biggest, heaviest box in the truck you can find. You wheel it home, and you open it up. And somewhere out in the yard, there's Brad Pitt screaming, "What's in the box? What's in the fucking box?"
It is possible that this was just the fringe team trying to stop the leader of the shapeshifters from crossing over into our universe.
Deep cut, Tara. That is a deep cut.
Did you make it to season 3 of Fringe?
I guess. Yes, it's a deep cut.
I'm not stealing any box that says human specimen, because I guarantee you there's something in there that I don't fucking want. I don't want your organs. I don't want your stool samples. I don't want your blood.
Lesser Godzilla says the box was addressed to Abby Normal. What part of human specimens did he not get? I don't know. But I don't.
That's, I mean, unless they were looking for a specific head.
Please are they still don't know where the box of heads are.
Ooh.
So there's this guy out there. You know, there's this guy out there just out on his porch, chain smoking, like, now what the fuck do I do?
Yeah.
Fuck. Maybe I. Fuck. What if I. Fuck.
I mean, you could put them on pikes around your yard. If you got problems with your neighbors,
just save them till Halloween. You know,
ooh. You won't have problems with porch pirates if you have heads on pikes in your yard. I'm concerned that a truck with a box of heads in it was left unattended from 2:30 p.m. to 9:30 a.m.
That's a long time. Vivi says, was it Army Hammer? Topical.
I think he only likes to eat women.
And not like that.
Yeah.
Just.
Oh, Denver.
We've never had. Yeah, this has never happened before.
I did see this story hit this week, and I was just like, what?
This has never happened.
I didn't know they hadn't found it yet.
Like, I have seen people come up with contraptions to discourage porch pirates, like the glitter spinner and all that shit.
Yeah.
Human heads in a box. That's a new one. That guy's going to think twice anytime he ever tries to steal anything ever again. Be like, okay, I could steal this, but there was also that time with the heads. So...
Yeah, like, what is that person doing right now? Unless they were specifically going for that box of heads, which only gives me more questions. Like, what are they doing right now?
Speaking of questions, if you could wonder what could possibly be worse than a box of human heads. Man rushed to hospital. I'll give you the link here. Can I just highlight the entire link, please? That would help. Man rushed to hospital after shoving battery into his penis.
The real ones don't work like that, honey.
It's not going to make your dick vibrate. Good hustle, but no. Man was rushed into hospital after shoving a battery into his penis. 49-year-old Iranian man had to be treated by medics after he inserted a AA battery. A AAA would be, I'd be sitting there going AAA, but a AA.
It could be worse. He could have gone for the C.
That's about, oh, God.
Or God help us, the 9-volt. Which isn't even round.
It's understood the battery had been in his penis for over a day.
What?
Before he went to a hospital in Tehran complaining about obstructive urinary symptoms.
Yeah.
Battery was removed without surgery after 24 hours, but the man was sent to the hospital again 5 months later as it had caused urinary blockage complications in his penis that required surgery. Medical team said they found urethral foreign bodies with rare and a variety of causes, including intoxication. Yeah, or someone's trying to be, you know.
You ever test a battery to see if it's live by touching it to your tongue?
No, Tara, I don't. Do you know how I test a battery, Tara? I've got a multimeter, Tara. I do not put...
No, but like even when you were a kid, if you weren't sure if a battery's live, you never licked it?
No, I never really? Did.
That's always how I did. Anyway.
We're learning things tonight.
If it's live, you get a little zap on the tongue. So my point is, was this battery live?
Well, apparently it was enough that it caused scar tissue to form just by being in there for 20. Yeah. What they had to do.
To pee.
What?
Can you imagine trying to pee on the live battery that is inside your urethra?
I mean, you're not supposed to whiz on the electric fence.
Exactly.
What do you do if. They have.
You guys really didn't lick the batteries?
Everybody here is just going. But
that's like the universal battery test. Come on. Is
Tara, the box had a little squeezy thing that if you squeeze
it
the
worked. Thing. It never worked. You get brand new batteries, you'd squeeze the thing and it wouldn't do anything. You had to lick them.
You did not have to lick them. You did not for the life of you have to lick them.
Maybe that's why my hair's so big.
What they had to do, he had scar tissue from doing this. So what they had to do is they had to go back in through the taint to fix this. Yeah, they had to go in and fix the scar tissue. Okay. Penis wielders. Dick holders. Do not put anything in the dick that was not designed to go in the dick. They make things, believe it or not, to go in the dick for fun times.
Mm-hmm.
If you would like to put something into your dick, please go and find one of these sterile, purpose-designed devices to go. Don't just be like, well, this is kind of round.
If you want to put anything in any of your orifices, please make it something designed for that purpose.
Right. We are a technologically advanced species. We have designed many things to go into all of our holes for a variety of deviant purposes.
Yeah. Please don't improvise.
What are you, some sort of caveman? What?
Why is there a picture of Benedict Cumberbatch at the end of this article?
I don't.
Oh, because they found a really dumb way to word pad.
I know, right?
They segued into how many actors are showing their dicks in movies this year.
So
what?
Yeah. And I want to point out, if you look at the entirety of this article, the top of the article is about Man Rush. And then the bottom of the article is Benedict Cumberbatch. So if you were just glancing at this, right? You would think Benedict Cumberbatch had shoved a battery in his penis.
Doctor Strange, indeed. That's not how you work a sling ring, sir.
Oh, so I guess.
Like, if I was Benedict Cumberbatch's agent,
I would
be fuming right now.
And it's got, they're using the dapper picture, too. He's like, Why, yes, I put a battery up my dick. Nice to meet you. I'm Benedict Cumberbatch.
I did it just like this.
So if it doesn't go in there, if it wasn't designed, if someone did not put a patent on putting that thing in your hole, don't put it in your hole.
Please just use the right tool for the job.
Just do improvise. Improvisation works fine in jazz, not your urethra.
Words to live by. Get that on a bumper sticker.
You say that, but if, you know what? If I did, someone would probably buy that. I would. We could probably sell those, and there'd be so many confused people out there.
Great. What? I don't understand.
We have learned that if you are a porch pirate, you're going to have to be careful about what you nick. Because
yeah, don't just rob any truck.
Sometimes, you know, you get like an iPad, and sometimes you get a box of human heads. You can't move those. You can't eBay them. People have tried. It doesn't go well. No, I'm serious. Like, people have tried.
What if it's like a real life Hannibal Lecter?
Moving on. We've learned that there are many ways to try and get out of work, but inventing a human is not going to be one that's successful.
Not long.
Like, yeah, you can get away with it for like a few days, but yeah. Eventually they're going to figure out that, you know, you made up a child. We've learned if you don't understand a religion, maybe don't, you know, just sort of like wing it. That's asking for trouble. We've learned that people will shove anything down their pants. Literally, and we have seen guitars. We have seen chainsaws. We have seen an assortment of meats and cheeses. Now we have weaponry. Now we have medieval weaponry. Great. Make a fucking list. And finally, we've learned, all right, maybe if, don't fuck with Ukrainians, I guess. Don't fuck with the fucking Ukrainians.
Mm-mm.
They are officially at the we do not give a fuck point.
Yeah. They will, and do you know, their president, I just found this out like yesterday, he's a year younger than me. If I live to be 200 years old, I will not be one-tenth as badass as that dude is now.
Somewhere, someone is currently carving my tombstone. Said that.